Otis. And why I think the fans turned on him after winning Money in the Bank. I don't know. I just feel that there's a lot of people that think that he might be too on the relatable side. Get why, because the majority of the marks are the smarks that I see, you know, on Twitter, or a lot of the fans that I've seen in different crowds and all that throughout the years look exactly like Otis, and I've seen a lot of people that look like Tucker. Yeah, like every time I go in like a grocery store or I'm at the movies or whatever, it's, you know, I've always seen people that look like him. And I don't really get exactly why he's not relatable. I feel that it's kind of an excuse to say that he's fat, you know, but they don't want to be like fat shamers. So instead of them just saying, hey, you know what, I don't like the guy because he's fat or that he's too chubby, you know, they will make the excuse that he shouldn't have won, you know, Money in the Bank, or they will do anything but blame Vince. They never put the blame on Vince as to why an idea then didn't work. If an idea or process didn't work, they won't blame Vince. They'll just go right to blaming, you know, Otis, or kind of saying that he is a comedy wrestler. And I say to that, yeah, bullshit. He is a comedy wrestler, but what does that have to do with him, you know, winning it? You know, you guys hadn't, you know, never had a problem with that before. You know, like right before, you know, before he won Money in the Bank, you guys were all over this guy. You guys were so in love with him. You know, like, you know, you thought he was funny and creative and this and that. And you love the fact that he got the girl, that, you know, that he got Mandy, and you guys were into the storyline. And then after he wins Money in the Bank, that all of a sudden, oh, I can't relate to him anymore. But why? Why? Because he won Money in the Bank. And like, so you mean to tell me that Otis tarnished? So you guys are pretending that Otis tarnished the Money in the Bank, you know, briefcase, he messed up the prestige of it. It hasn't been a prestigious thing in a while now. You can't really blame Otis for, you know, for Money in the Bank type of drama, because you have to kind of blame, you know, Vince. You know, I blame Vince 100% for that. You know, he kind of saw Otis as like flavor of the month type of thing. And so, it's kind of sad that Vince doesn't think that way of him anymore. And I always, you know, and I'm just of the opinion, that it's kind of unrealistic to think of yourself as being like a big, strong, or powerful, like a Drew McIntyre, or, you know, or like an Aleister Black, or this and that, because in real life, I know that that's not what you guys look like. I mean, I've never seen anybody that looks like that in real life. You know, those people look like freaks to me. So I don't know exactly. I've never met anybody that looks like Braun Strowman, or anybody that looks like any of these people. I've never seen anybody that looks like any of these wrestlers, not, like, not one time. You know, that's a, you know, a bit weird. I've seen more people that look like Otis and Tucker than I have of you know, of like Drew McIntyre. I mean, how many people do you know looks like Drew McIntyre? I'm saying, like, in real, like, in real life. Because if I'm being honest with you, you know, you're gonna say, yeah, I've never met anybody that looks like him. And I've never met anybody that looks like that. I've met people that look a lot like Otis and Tucker. I've never met anybody that looks like a Drew McIntyre. Okay, like a lot of people's standards are a little bit, like, you know, unrealistic. You know, like I love Sasha Banks and I enjoy her work, but I'm never gonna look like her. So hey, some things you kind of have to be a little bit, you know, like on the realistic side about. I think some of the fans, and like not all, but some of the fans that are turning on Otis, you know, like don't believe that he should have won, you know, the briefcase and think that Miz is better. But I don't think Miz is really that great. You know, he's not really a relatable guy at all. And I think if he really wanted, you know, kind of, you know, some entertaining type of stuff, it should have been booked for that. It should have been John Morrison. John Morrison should actually have the briefcase. Yeah, because he's a little bit more and more talented than the Miz is, and he has more. The offense. His offense is better than the Miz's in the ring. The Miz is a bit bland, but I always felt that the Morrison was more talented of the two. He has a lot more talent. And I just think his personality really does shine. But for some reason, Vince just doesn't really like the guy. So that's kind of my take on that. I do believe that Otis is buried. I think he's getting buried because he just lost to, you know, to Seth Rollins on SmackDown not too long ago. And he was in like a qualifying match for a Survivor Series, and he just lost to him. I mean, he just lost to Seth. And I'm just like, man, like I can't relate to Seth at all, especially now with the Messiah gimmick. He needs a brand new gimmick. Talk about someone who needs a gimmick change. It's Seth. His Messiah gimmick is starting to kind of suck now. It's starting to get sour like fucking milk now. Yeah, he needs another gimmick. Like, I mean, really. Yeah, I think 2021 that guy needs a brand new gimmick. But I think in a lot of ways, I think so does Otis and Tucker need brand new gimmicks too, especially Otis. You know, I think if Vince has a problem with him, you know, so much, then why did you put the briefcase on him? You know, to begin with, why did you put the briefcase on him from the jump? If you knew that. If he knew that you weren't going to do anything with him after he won, that's what doesn't make any sense to me. You know, you doing all this stuff, you know, because you think it's funny, or that he can't climb the ladder, that he, you know, he's breaking the steps and all that. Like, that's like none of that shit is funny. You know, you doing all this stuff with like putting them and turning the briefcase into a lunchbox and shit like that. Like, that's not hilarious to me. Like, that's not funny. That's not putting anybody over. No, you're fat shaming him. You're fat shaming Otis. And that will never be okay with me. Fat shaming will never be allowed. That should never be allowed. You know? And that is unacceptable. And Vince is a trash ass person for that. He will forever be trash in my opinion. But I'm getting on a tangent now. That's kind of a different story altogether. I have to make a different video on Vince. And let me know if you want me to talk about how Vince is a loser and how I think Vince fucking sucks. So, let me know about that. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. it's just kind of frustrating because he really is like a lovable guy, and there were so many things you could have done with him. You know, you could have had like a marriage angle with him and Mandy, and then be some drama with that. You know, you could have had Otis and Tucker win the tag team belts on SmackDown. You know, there's like a lot of stuff that you could have done instead of Tucker turning on Otis, and so now Tucker is like getting jobbed out on Raw now, and that just does not make any fucking sense to me whatsoever. Like, what is going on? Like, what kind of shit is that? I mean, he's just like a total jobber now, and as far as Otis, he's just getting buried, you know, on SmackDown now. He's really is not getting a fair shake, like fair treatment. He's being underutilized on SmackDown, you know, now. Ever since losing the briefcase to The Miz, he has not been doing anything. Like, Vince does not give a shit about Otis anymore. And to me, like, that fucking sucks. Like, that is sad to me. That is depressing to me. He really is like a sweetheart. And for people not to see that, or for fans, not to say, hey, you know what, I can relate to this guy, then there's something wrong with you. Not Otis. Otis is not the problem. It's obviously you. That sounds like a personal issue that you gotta work through on your own. Yeah, that's. I don't think that's an Otis problem. That sounds like a you problem. But anyway, yeah, I'm done for now. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. If you want me to do more content like this or more videos like this, just let me know. And I will do them. As always, everybody has an opinion.